Hello everybody, I'm Pranav and I would like to take you through the travel solutions that we are building for a billion Indians. So overall, if you look at this chart, I mean, India has a population of 1.2 billion. The number of smartphone users is still very small, and broadband users is still lower than that. But unfortunately, those are the segments for which most of the travel companies are building solutions, and to some extent, we've been guilty of that as well. And nobody is thinking about the masses and the rest of the population at all. So that is the focus that Make My Trip has taken. And we've basically realized that SMS is a really big channel for communication to that audience. And we are building a bunch of apps on SMS, a bunch of apps on feature phones. And obviously, we have our offerings on smartphone and websites. And I'll just quickly take you through all of these offerings. So on SMS, we have over 10 plus solutions already available where you can, if you're going to a new city, you want a city guide, you want to find out what attractions to see in those leisure destinations, you can get all of that on SMS. If you're going abroad, visa rules, if you want to search for flight results. So all of these options are available. And in fact, the most recent thing that we've launched is bus bookings on SMS, where you can make payments through IMPS, which is also a platform that's being used at IRCTC at this point. So this is just an example of how some of our results show up when you query on SMS. So this is an example of flight search. If you use, if you want directions, so you can get step-by-step directions from between Rohini to Saket in this example. The one that I would like to spend more time on is the route planner application. So this solves a unique problem that in India, there are 4,300 cities, and very few of those, I mean, only 92 airports exist. Now, 4,300 cities equates to around 18.5 million city pairs, out of which less than 2% have direct connectivity through air, bus, trains, all combined, which means that in most cases, if you want to go from one city to another in India, you need to combine multiple transport options to get there. So this example shows that if you want to go from Jalandhar to New Delhi, how do you get there? And this sort of suggests that, hey, you can take a train to Delhi. From there, you can take a flight to Thiruvananthapuram, and from there, you can take a cab. And this is a one-stop solution where if you want to go from any point in India to any other point, it will give you the best possible options to go there. The routes are ranked by convenience and affordability to cater to the Indian audience, and it goes on to the level of detail where if we know that a train is arriving in the New Delhi station at 11 and it would take almost 2 hours from there to get to the airport, and you need to reach the airport 1 hour in advance for the flight, so it will not give you any flight options which are within that 3 hour window. It will give you only options that follow after that. And just to give you a little more sense of the complexity of this problem, so there are a bunch of routes independently for all transportation options, and bus routes, 65,000 are bookable, and there are a bunch of other routes which are non-bookable. What this means is that if you pick up any two cities in India, and if you want to say that I want to find out all possible routes from one city to the other with at most three hops, that equates to around 27 billion combinations from where you need to find the best route. And if you were to do that for across all cities in India, it would take 1,000 servers 3.5 years to compute that. So we have devised an algo that solves this problem and addresses this, answers this question in less than a second. So it's a fairly hard technical problem. And in order to get it to a really large population, we've also partnered with Nokia to bring this as an app on the Nokia Asha platform. And this app has been launched a week back. In addition, of course, we have our booking applications on smartphones available on Android, iOS, BlackBerry, coming soon on Windows, where you can independently book flight tickets, bus tickets, hotels, holiday packages. You can manage your bookings, make cancellations, make corrections, check flight status, find places to eat nearby. So all of those things are available. And we have two flavors of our mobile sites, one of which works for feature phones, which is very, very lightweight and very low on graphics, and the other one, which works fairly similar to our apps, which works on full-screen touch phones. So just to conclude quickly, I mean, the summary, the points that I would like all of you to take away from this are that we have realized that SMS is the broadest communication medium, and that's what we are going after to enable everybody with travel services. We need innovations like Route Planner in India, which enable people to find out how to get from one point to another for their business reasons or leisure or whatever. And at this point, we believe that since there is a significant population that's been excluded from the travel services as of now, transactions will take some time to come. So we are currently focused on just providing services, getting the reach. And if people use our services, at least we'll be happy about that. Transactions will naturally follow. That's what we believe. So thank you all for listening in.
Thank you. Any questions?
Yeah.
I thank and congratulate with the route planner, but it will be more successful if the data is more up to date. Now with the private players and also even static, let us say train is static only twice a year, they change, but delays are there every day. How you are getting this updated information day to day?
Okay.
From multiple sources.
Yeah. So basically the good thing is that we started off as an OTA. So we already used to sell flights and trains and bus tickets. So in that sense, we have all the schedule and pricing information available. And that is what basically goes in as an input to this particular system. Behind the scenes, there is a really large graph database which maps every single city with every other city through all possible routes and schedules. And that gets updated as and when we have a new feed coming in for each of the verticals. And that is how we basically make sure that at any point in time when you query on Route Planner, you get a near real-time price for the consolidated option. For all cases, it may not always be the freshest price. For example, flight prices change very dynamically. So it may be that if we refresh once a day, there will be some prices which are stale. But if you, for example, search a couple days in advance, then in most cases you will get an up-to-date price.
Okay. Now, second thing is you said payment also you are accepting through for the
right,
SMS.
Right.
How you are accepting the payment?
So payment works pretty much in a similar way as it does on our website. So if you've used the Make My Trip website, there is an option after you've chosen the.
That's okay. Technology, yeah. I'm talking about GPRS.
Yeah. So you need to be connected to either GPRS or a 3G connection.
Okay.
And then,
okay.
Then you can choose one of the available options to make a payment.
Yeah, please.
Hi.
I had a simple question. You have done the SMS and you have done the feature phone. Now, what is the comparison of people actually using it and booking tickets on the SMS platform as opposed to, of course, on the feature phone you have?
Yeah.
What is
so,
the ratio?
So if you notice, none of the offerings that we have either on SMS or on feature phones are actually booking offerings. They are purely informational. We have just enabled bus bookings, I think, a week or two back. So the data for that is yet to come. Even Route Planner is a purely informational service at this point. In general, from our mobile sites, I can say that most of the transactions currently, 70% plus are happening on smartphones, and a smaller number are happening on feature phones.
Yeah, there were other hands here.
Yeah. So this Route Planner product that you've launched, so I just wanted to check on the transaction part, but I think you mentioned that it's not supporting transactions now. But later on, let's say if whenever you'll add, like you've added for the bus, so it'll be like I'll see the route and I'll say whatever, I'll take the total amount and you'll give me the ticket for all the three possible options on SMS?
Exactly. That's the idea. And we may not do transactions on SMS for Route Planner.
Okay.
But we definitely have it in the roadmap for the feature phone app. So we would love to see how many people actually use it on Nokia Asha. And once people start adopting it, we would love to push it into add one more step to have a consolidated payment system for all the transport options suggested.
Thank you.
I think there was another one raising your hand. Is there? Yeah, please.
Kind of selected my route. How do I get that information onto save it to my own personal listing? So I normally do a search much in advance and I don't really book at that point of time. Is there a provision for saving in search which is there, and then some way to export that data into some other
absolutely.
Format.
Absolutely. So when you use our app, what you'll realize is that the actionable link at the end of a route is email this route. So the idea is that you would want to store that route in your email, or you would want to share it with some other folks to discuss and plan for that trip. And that is the endpoint for the apps at this point. For SMS, the moment you do a query, you anyway get the response in your SMS, so that's stored in your phone, and you can forward it to anybody you want. So in both cases, you have the route available for you to discuss later.
One more add-on question. Is there a facility available for voice inputs or some kind of voice-based transaction for searching?
So we have dabbled with voice inputs a little bit as an experimental feature. What we have realized is that all the existing engines now, be it Google Voice or be it the Samsung engines that exist in smartphones, they are able to understand US accents or European accents, but they don't work with Indian accents yet. So we are still figuring out a good way in order to get those engines working with Indian accents. I think once that maturity is there, then we would actually launch it publicly.
One last question. Any localization?
Pardon?
Any localization of the app in Indian languages?
So not yet, and that's something we are deliberating again as well. So one of the things that historically, since till last year, we were also building apps for smartphones. We believe that most people, even if they consume content in local languages for smartphones, they are actually English aware and they can go and transact in English. So that's why we didn't build any smartphone apps in local languages. As far as SMS services are concerned, we definitely have a much stronger plan to convert all of that content and make SMS services available in local languages. And that's something that you'll see in a couple of months from now.
Thank you, Pranav.
Okay. Thank you.